Nos encontramos con el doctor Jeffrey Lagrasso, uno de nuestros cirujanos aquí en My Cosmetic Surgery, y queremos que nos hable sobre una de las cirugías más populares en el mundo entero y aquí, sobre la liposucción. Buenas, doctor, gracias por concedernos esta entrevista. Y la primera pregunta es, ¿qué es una liposucción?
Liposuction is, by definition, we're removing fat from the body using a cannula. Everyone always kind of gets liposuction and liposculpture. They think it's two different things, but in essence, it's just one thing with two different names. Because the whole purpose of liposuction is to create a shape. We're using the cannula to remove the fat, to create the contour, to create the curve in the body, to get the desired shape. So it's sculpting using a cannula, removing fat.
¿La lipo es un método para bajar de peso?
It's not intended specifically to be used as a weight loss tool. It's more for sculpting and shaping. But just based upon my experience, depending on the size of the patient, people will lose anywhere between 5 to 15 pounds, depending on if you're on the thinner side or on the heavier side.
¿Quiénes son los candidatos perfectos para una liposucción?
You know, liposuction could be done on people who are thin and people who are heavier. The expectations may be a little bit different. In someone who's thinner and in better shape, you know, we use it more to really enhance and define the body, to be specific in what we're doing and to carve out little details. And people who are a little bit heavier, it's, you know, turning people who are cuadrada or who are shaped square to creating that curve. So it can be used for both, and we do so all the time. There is no ideal weight. Like I said, it could be, you know, people who are thinner and people are heavier. It's just the idea is just to manage the expectations about what we can and what we can't accomplish. But people of all weights are capable of doing liposuction.
¿Cómo es el proceso de recuperación de una lipo, doctor?
For recovery, typically for liposuction, most people are back to work within 5 to 7 days. You're going to be swollen for a couple of months. You know, typically by the end of, you know, 3-4 months, most of the swelling is gone. You do have to wear a faja, a garment, for 3 months to help compress the skin, to help, you know, eliminate some of that swelling faster. You know, pain pills, 2-3 days, not too terribly discomforting an operation. To expedite the recovery process, I do recommend lymphatic massages. You can start them the first day after the operation. You know, somewhere between 5 or 10 of them within the first week or two is ideal.
¿Y qué es la transferencia de grasa a los glúteos, o fat transfer?
Fat transfer is when we're taking fat from one area of the body and we're moving it somewhere else. Typically here, we're taking fat from the abdomen and we're taking it from the back and we're transferring it into the gluteus, into the buttocks. That fat that we're transferring, most people tend to keep around 40 to 60% of the fat that we're putting in there. Very important, the recovery is a little bit different. You know, no sitting for the first 10 days after the operation to protect the fat that we put in there. But the fat that we put in, we kind of put in fine, thin little lines so that the new blood vessels from the surrounding tissue grow into the fat to make the fat survive.
¿La transferencia de grasa se puede combinar con otras cirugías?
You can, in specific patients. And that's something that I select depending on, you know, what the patient wants to do and what the other procedures are. You know, it tends to be better in people who are thinner and heavier, because a lot of times the recovery is different. With fat transfer, you know, you want to not sit for 10 days and you want to kind of lay on your stomach. Say we're doing a tummy tuck, you kind of want to stay on your back and be flexed to protect the incision from tension. So it becomes a recovery issue. So in certain select patients, you know, I will do both of them together. Sometimes it's just best to break them up into two operations so that you get the best result from both operations.
Doctor, si la paciente tiene una hernia, ¿se podría hacer la liposucción?
Yeah, we can do hernias all the time. It's not a problem. You know, if it's a hernia that's amenable to be fixed in the office, I can fix it. Sometimes I use mesh, sometimes I don't use mesh, depending on the location and so forth. But if it's a big hernia that requires, you know, hospitalization, that would typically be done with a general surgeon beforehand, and then we would come back and do the liposuction afterwards. But yes, we do liposuction and fix hernias all the time.
Muchísimas gracias, doctor, por su tiempo y por esas respuestas tan esclarecedoras para tantas pacientes que siempre tienen algunas dudas y algunas preocupaciones con respecto a su cirugía.
Gracias.